It's on, Dad.
Sometimes I question my sanity. Sometimes I feel like the whole world has gone mad. It's been 100 years, but the Armenian people are still searching for answers. They say we should move on. The Turkish government still hasn't taken the responsibility. But mark my words, nothing goes unpunished. Not something like this. The Armenian people will have their answers. We just have to be patient.
Dad, has Grandma told you anything about her experience in Turkey?
I told you everything you needed to know. By the way, how did your school report go?
The professor said it was one-sided. Dad, there was a specific detail that Grandma was leaving off. Was there a promise made? And if there was it kept? Who's the promise made to? When did it happen? Who are those people?
Oh, so many questions. Settle down, you're making my head spin.
Sorry, there's just so much void in the story.
Well, first of all, you have to stop asking Grandma about those tats. You're a big girl. By now you've figured out what they mean. You know, for an Armenian woman to talk about rape is like betraying all those generations of women before her. Being a woman is very sacred. Her memory of those events had become muddled over the years. But there is something that just stuck in my head. She said there was a man who sacrificed his seat on the boat for Grandma and her pregnant mother. They were crossing the river the night before Turkish guards entered the village. Her father was arrested before. She was only 8, so some details of that event are not quite defined. But she told me that the man and her mother had a secretive conversation as he was stepping off the boat.
A relative, maybe?
All I know is that the man said her mother had to keep the promise.
I overheard Tatik mumbling something to herself before she collapsed. It was something about keeping the promise. And the curse.
The curse?
Yes, the curse in that they didn't keep the promise. Dad, you gotta help me. Is there anybody else who might know?
This might be useless to you, but your mom and your grandma have been visiting a psychic in the valley.
What?
I tease your mom about it because, you know, we're not those kind of people.